And he begins to build you up and strengthen you up so that he opens up the doors of the heaven and pours you out a blessing that you won't have room enough to receive. And then you can pour that blessing out into the lives of other folk who are hungering and thirsting and burdened down. Maybe for 18 years. And then we can get our sure enough shout party on. Because when you walk in here and you say, oh man, the Lord, Pastor, I got to tell you what the Lord did for me this week. And because in God's formula, the pie doesn't get smaller when he slices it out and gives a piece to somebody else. It actually gets bigger. I can rejoice in your blessing. Because your family told that ruler, this is a daughter of Abraham. This is your family. I can rejoice in the blessing because your family. And it also gives me hope and an assurance that, hey, man, the same God, Daddy, that just blessed into your life when you were dealing with the stuff that felt like it was insurmountable is the same God that's my daddy that can deal with the stuff that I'm dealing with right now that feels like it's overwhelming. And if he's working, I mean, if he's still in the blessing business, and I know that he is because he's already blessed them and he's blessed you, and now then let me come on down to the house of prayer and let for every, one more time and see what God's got for me down here on Sunday morning. And I'm sure there's a blessing that's got my name on it. Is there a blessing with your name on it, preachers? I'm finished. I just wanted to join in. You know, they were having too much shouting fun in the Bible here, and I didn't want them to run on off without me. Because I can get happy that she got her blessing. I can get happy because the ruler got his blessing if he would pay any attention to it. Jesus spoke into him, so not... Jesus wasn't putting the man down like he had to assume some position over. This was the creator of the universe. So when he spoke into him, he technically was giving him an opportunity to turn from his foolishness and turn toward the creator of the universe. This is the pastor's interpretation. When he took him to the donkey to the illustration, it was to show him just how foolish it is for you to make that statement on the Sabbath, in the synagogue, talking to the creator of the universe. You think that because you got a title in here and a little bit of the degree behind you, that you think you know something about the word that I created, Jesus said. Talk to me like you're still in the house. And his blessing was if he would just pay attention, listen, and learn, his heart would have been changed, his mind would have been expanded, and not only would the woman have gotten a blessing from being released from her infirmity, this ruler would have gotten a blessing from being loose from his ignorance. Ruler, thou art loose. But some folk got to go a different road. Some folk need a little more nudging. But I've got good news for the rebellious among us. If you're still breathing, if you can hear the words that are coming from my mouth, then there is still hope for you. God's not finished yet with you. And you can act a fool as long as you want to act a fool. And keep getting the consequences and the return on your foolish investment that you're going to get. Or you can come to Jesus and let him bring healing and hope and health and happiness to your life. Come to Jesus. Musicians are coming, and if I stay here much longer, I will have preached the next segment of this. But I don't want us to leave this house of prayer, this home of the family, without making sure that you feel, as we said, this We design love into our time together. So we're gonna open up the doors of the church and extend the arms of the family. New members, directors are gonna come down front. And we're gonna just ask you to stand. And if the Lord is moving on your heart and you're seeking a church home family, we're gonna ask you to come down front and let us welcome you. Simple on your Christian experience or as a candidate for baptism. It's a simple process here. Because this is not a social club, we don't vote you in, don't vote you out. This is a family, and we welcome you. So if the Lord is moving on your heart, would you take a step of faith today and come down front and let us welcome you home? The doors of the church are open. Musicians are playing. We'll start singing it together. You ought to know him. Get to know him. Right now, today. Now let's begin to lift our voices. There's nothing better than knowing Jesus. The doors are open. Won't you take a step of faith? Let us welcome you home. Pick you up and turn your life around. There's no better time than right now, no better place than right here. You ought to know him, get to know him. Right now, today.
Right now, today.
There's nothing better than knowing Jesus. Take that step today, you ought to know him. Get to know him. And then because we love you, we open our arms to you. We just say, come on, come on, come on. Take our neighbors by the hand, but if the Lord moves on your heart before you leave this building today, feel free to come on down and let us take your information. Welcome you home. We will introduce you to the family. With our heads bowed, with our eyes closed, and with our hearts humbled before the living God, assuming an attitude of prayer, lifting our hands to him in praise. Now unto him who is able to keep you and me from falling, and present us faultless before the presence of his glory with exceeding joy. To the only wise God, our Savior, be glory, majesty, dominion, power, now, henceforth, and forevermore. Let all God's people say amen and amen. Holy.
Holy, holy,
Lord God Almighty, God in three persons. Blessed Trinity.
Blessed Trinity.
God God bless you and God keep you. Give somebody a hug before you leave today. Invite somebody new to church next Sunday. Bless them with an opportunity to come.